Previously on this channel, I've demonstrated various web frameworks for Python, but with most of them, the front end, the HTML, CSS, JavaScript side of things, you still had to write all that in those languages using templates or some other mechanisms. FastHTML is a new Python web framework that handles both front and back end through pure Python. The HTML you return to the client can be declared programmatically in Python and automatically wired up for interaction with the HTMX JavaScript framework. And you can always drop back to using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript manually, but the vast majority of your work can be done entirely in Python. So let's look at some examples from simple to a little more elaborate. This is a basic FastHTML app, and if you've used other web frameworks for Python like Flask, the general design should look familiar. We use decorators to indicate what functions handle what routes in our app, and also what methods. And we have an app object that we use to run the app itself or to manage it. The default route creates some basic HTML. We have a div with a single h1 element in it that reads "Hello World." The div is also wired up with a piece of HTMX-powered interactivity. If the client clicks on the div or any element in it, the contents of the div are replaced with whatever is going to be returned from the route change. All that is declared through this hx_get argument. We can also manually declare class or style information on an element using keyword arguments. And down here, the change route returns another h1 element with a different text. So if we run this and we fire up a web browser, we see our "Hello World" message. And when we click on it, we get the changed text in our div. Another nice thing you get for free with FastHTML, at least when you're doing development, is automatic reloading when you change your code base. I'm going to change the style declaration for our div. And as you can see, when I save the Python file, the application senses changes automatically and restarts the app. I reload the page, and our changes show up immediately. Let's take a look at a more advanced example. This is taken from FastHTML's own examples directory. I've linked to it down in the description. And it's a simple to-do app backed by an SQLite database with a simple authentication system implemented as middleware. Now, in theory, you could use any database system you wanted with FastHTML, but FastHTML comes with its own convenient way to create and manage simple SQLite data stores. These lines here check for an existing database, and if it doesn't exist, it creates it with the columns ID, title, done, and a primary key accessed through our app by way of a data class object. All the interactions with the DB are pretty high level and convenient. Now, when we create our app object for this app, we have a couple of arguments passed in to control how it behaves. The headers argument lets us supply headers in the HTML automatically on every page. In this case, it's going to be the picolink style sheet, which is included by default with FastHTML, and some additional CSS styling we're supplying manually. For the middleware argument, we're supplying a user password authentication routine for every page. The user is user, and this here will be the password. Don't do this in production, please. The rest of the app is our routes for reading the list of to-dos, adding new ones, and editing existing ones. You'll notice that the HTML construction code is pretty easy to make sense of at a glance. This block here under the edit route, it creates a form. It populates it with controls, and it uses HTMX to describe what the form target is and what HTTP verb to use. In this case, it's put, and that's handled in this route here. So let's fire this app up and take it for a spin. So first, we're prompted for a username and password to access the site. And once we give those, we get a blank to-do list. I can add things to do by just typing and hitting enter. I can edit an existing item by clicking on its edit link, or I can change the name or mark it as complete. And I can remove items by clicking the name and selecting delete. What's key about all this is how we have implemented it in about 70 lines of pure Python. There are no HTML templates, no JavaScript includes. All of this is generated and supplied by FastHTML. Now, FastHTML is still quite new compared to mature frameworks like Flask and Django, or even FastAPI. Its documentation is still somewhat thin, although the examples included are useful to dig into. But it certainly has my attention, and even in its early stages, it shows a viable paradigm for how websites can be created purely with Python, including their front ends. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.